I want to share with you guys today a really interesting research study all about how as adolescents, if you perceive your weight to be higher than it actually is, it actually has a negative impact on your weight trajectory later in life. And so this whole research study was all about how there was individuals who are a normal weight, but perceived themselves to be higher than they were, or overweight or obese. And then those individuals who perceived themselves to be at a higher weight than they actually objectively were, ended up gaining more weight later in life than the group of individuals at a normal weight who perceived their weight as normal. So I'll explain all of this a little bit more detail when we actually talk about research, but this study is just super interesting to go over how it's so important that we really work on body image, not only throughout our whole life, but specifically in those adolescent years. So this research study was done in Norway. They took about 1,100 adolescents, specifically with 649 girls and 547 boys. Their ages were roughly 13 to 19. The average age of the study was about 15, okay? And remember I said that they really wanted to make sure that these people were objectively speaking a normal weight. So they did use BMI, and the average BMI of the participants was 20. Okay, so an average BMI of 20, so objectively speaking, we're talking they were within that normal BMI category. Yes, I know we don't love to use BMI, but this research used it and it's very interesting. So what they did is they had all of these people answer some survey questions. And the survey was all about their activity and all of this lifestyle stuff, but one question that they were focusing on very specifically was how they perceived their body. So there was essentially a ranking scale, and they were asked, do they perceive themselves as underweight? Do they perceive themselves as normal weight? Do they perceive themselves as overweight, obese? It was a little bit more specific like that, but it was essentially this scale to see how they perceive themselves. And what they found is that 22% of the girls and 9% of the boys perceived themselves as either overweight or obese, even though, remember, they were in that normal BMI category. So then what they did is actually follow up years later, okay? So the average age at follow-up was about 27. Remember, when they first did this study, the average age was about 15. And then they followed up at 27 to see how their weight had changed. And what they actually found is that the individuals who perceived themselves as overweight or obese gained more weight throughout that cycle than the individuals who perceived themselves as normal weight. Specifically, the BMI of the individuals who perceived themselves as overweight or obese was 0.88 higher than the individuals who perceived themselves as normal weight. So I know that's kind of a lot of technical terms, but in a nutshell, what they're saying here is they took a bunch of normal weight adolescents, asked them how they perceive themselves. The ones that at that moment thought that they were too fat or thought that they were bigger than they were, whatever it might be, ended up gaining more weight later in life than the individuals who perceive themselves to be normal weight or underweight. Isn't that interesting? So the reason that they did, and they talked all about this in the discussion, and they did try to compound for socioeconomic status and physical activity and all of these other factors. And one of the big things that they actually figured out is they do think that it has to do with how people would have changed their diet based on how they perceived themselves. What they found out and what they discussed, and actually their purporting needs a little bit more research into, was that what they found based on these questions and at the follow-up when people were average age of 27, that a lot of people had actually switched to unhealthy dietary patterns. They found that a lot of people started skipping breakfast or doing some sort of diet or did something based on their self-perceived overweight or obese status. Now remember, none of these people, objectively speaking, needed to lose weight or should have lost weight or done anything. It was just purely based on this perception that they were too big. And so what they found is that these people did actually change their dietary patterns in one way or another. They then actually lead this to another study that's called Dieting Makes You Fat, which I think I've talked about before, and if not, I'll do another video on, but all about how individuals who find themselves on this constant cycle of losing weight and regaining weight end up gaining more weight than when they started. And that's essentially what they figured out with this study. So what happened is all these people who were normal weight thought that they were too big, thought that they needed to lose weight, did some unhealthy dietary changes, and then ultimately later in life they ended up gaining more weight than they just naturally would have, or maybe not gained at all. Now, I thought this was really important to point out because, of course, as you guys know, one of the big things that's important to me is fueling your body well. And I think especially in those early years, like high school, early college, is when we find that people start to try to do lots of different diets or change their body in one way or another. And this is my pitch to you to please try to not do that. Or if you really do just want to add more vegetables to your day or exercise because you're not someone who was usually physically active, add that in an appropriate way. Remember, one thing that's good to do is set realistic goals. Instead of saying that you're going to clean out your whole pantry and change everything that you eat, maybe just try to add some more vegetables to the plate that you already make yourself for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Or when it comes to physical activity, try to get out there and go on a walk for 20 minutes every single day, as opposed to starting some intense HIIT workout where you're gonna do 7 days a week for 2 hours. It all comes down to moderation, and this study is just so interesting to prove that that's definitely true, and we wanna fuel our bodies well for happier, healthier, older selves. Don't forget to like and subscribe, guys. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments.